Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Just as we were hoping that people in this country couldn't stoop any lower, along comes someone and outdoes himself to reach a depth we had thought couldn't be achieved. This time the Daily Caller is reporting that an Oregon congressional candidate by the name of Mark Roberts thought it would be a good idea to insult the First Lady Melania Trump on Twitter yesterday, by none the less than implying she works as a prostitute. This all started when Charlie Kirk decided to draw a comparison on Twitter as to how First Lady Melania Trump only has 5 staffers when former First Lady Michelle Obama had 44. Did you know, there are 39 fewer staffers dedicated to the First Lady of the United States, FLOTUS, than under Obama. Trending, huge Trump banner just unfurled at Yankee Stadium and infuriates every liberal there. There are only 5 staffers dedicated to Melania Trump versus 44 staffers who served Michelle Obama. Charlie Kirk at Charlie Kirk 11, July 30, 2018. What was she even doing with 44 staffers? Anyways, Roberts later responded by asking Kirk if he knew the First Lady works by the hour. And to make matters even worse, he placed hashtags on the words, think dirty, and, ho bag, did you know the First Lady works by the hour? Hashtag think dirty, hashtag ho bag, Mark Roberts, at Roberts for CD2, July 30th, 2018. The most interesting part of this whole sick saga is the fact that if you look on this guy's website, you learn that he, in fact, calls himself an independent, with moderate conservative positions. What in the world does that even mean? He sure doesn't act like a conservative. He looks more like a plant to try to make conservatives look bad. When the Daily Caller News Foundation, which isn't related to the Daily Caller website, reached out to Roberts' congressional campaign for a statement on his comments, they later received an email from what appears to be Roberts himself, where he says, "Sorry Nick, never heard of the Daily Caller. I think I'm too big for you, but feel free to send me a link to some of your work." The DCNF then asked Roberts why he chose the phrases, think dirty, and, ho bag, to describe First Lady Melania Trump and whether or not he thinks it's appropriate to describe the First Lady in that fashion. He answered, I think the answers to your questions are self-explanatory. Have a god sick day and keep the donations coming. After seeing his responses, maybe what this man really needs is some serious mental evaluation. There is something wrong when an adult, especially one who is running for public office, acts this way. Let's hope and pray he gets the help he needs before he hurts someone, or himself. Here is more on our wonderful First Lady via the White House. Melania Trump was born on April 26, 1970 in Slovenia. At age 16, she began what would soon become a highly successful modeling career, appearing in many high-profile ad campaigns and working with some of the best photographers in the fashion industry. In 1996, Mrs. Trump moved to New York and 10 years later, she proudly became a United States citizen. Mrs. Trump has always been an active member of her community. In 2005, she was honorary chairwoman for the Martha Graham Dance Company. That same year, she was awarded Goodwill Ambassador by the American Red Cross, a role she served in for 4 years. Mrs. Trump served 5 years as honorary chairwoman for the Boys Club of New York and was named Woman of the Year in 2006 by the Police Athletic League. Mrs. Trump has participated in National Love Our Children Day and National Child Abuse Prevention Month, ringing the closing bell at NASDAQ. In 2010, Mrs. Trump was the chairwoman for the American Heart Association, which raised $1.7 million for research. That same year, she launched her own jewelry collection. While Melania Trump became a household name in modeling and a contributing member of her community, she is first and foremost a mother and wife, and in 2017, Melania Trump made the White House and Washington home for her family. In her role as First Lady, Mrs. Trump focuses her time on the many issues affecting children. An unwavering characteristic of the First Lady is her aptitude for showing love and compassion in all that she does. Mrs. Trump spends much of her time meeting with children who are patients at hospitals and care centers. Recently, she took Valentine's to the Children's Inn at the National Institutes of Health in Cincinnati Children's Hospital. Over the Easter holiday, she made a surprise visit to St. Mary's Medical Center in Palm Beach, Florida, bringing Easter baskets to the children. Following the devastating hurricanes last year, Mrs. Trump visited Texas to meet with families that suffered greatly under Hurricane Harvey. In the wake of 2 horrendous mass shootings, Mrs. Trump traveled with her husband to Las Vegas and Parkland to be with the victims and families in their times of need. Internationally, Mrs. Trump has visited several hospitals and schools. One of her most memorable visits being at the pediatric hospital Bambino Gesù in the Vatican City, where she met a boy who had been waiting for a new heart. Upon arrival in Belgium the following day, Mrs. Trump learned that the hospital had found a transplant for the boy. Mrs. Trump celebrated the news in a press statement and said, "My own heart is filled with joy over the news." As First Lady, Mrs. Trump has made multiple visits to schools, both foreign and domestic. From participating in a Viking Huddle class, which focuses on emotional learning at Orchard Lake Middle School in Michigan, to taking the Queen of Jordan to Washington, D.C.'s first public charter school for girls at Excel Academy in Southeast, Mrs. Trump is always bringing children to the forefront of her agenda. While traveling abroad, Mrs. Trump visited the American International School in Riyadh, Saudi Arabia, with Education Minister Ahmed Al-Aissa, and took a calligraphy lesson with local children at Kyobashi Tsukiji Elementary School with Mrs. Abe while visiting Japan. Earlier this spring, Mrs. Trump invited a group of local students to the White House so she could talk with them, hear their stories, and understand the issues they are challenged with today. Mrs. Trump addresses those issues each opportunity she gets. From governor's spouses' luncheons to the United Nations General Assembly, Mrs. Trump puts the emphasis on children and how we can protect them, teach them, and empower them. In the midst of the opioid epidemic, Mrs. Trump has utilized her platform as First Lady to raise awareness about the dangers of opioid abuse, notably the devastating effects it has on infants and unborn babies. Mrs. Trump traveled to Huntington, West Virginia, where she visited Lily's Place, the nation's first non-profit infant recovery center that prioritizes the whole family to ensure infants born dependent on drugs are given the best opportunity to thrive. More recently, in February, Mrs. Trump traveled to Ohio to visit Cincinnati Children's, a leading pediatric hospital where she learned more about the ongoing research around neonatal abstinence syndrome, NAS, a harmful result of drug abuse in pregnant mothers. Mrs. Trump has participated in multiple opioid summits and continues to work with the administration on raising the awareness of opioid abuse and how we can better protect children from it. Note from the editor, the views and opinions expressed in this article are those of the authors and do not necessarily reflect the position of this website or of the owners, administrators of where this article is shared online. Claims are made in this piece are based on the author's own opinion and not stated as evidence of fact.